You know, I left the department in the end of 2021 after 5 years of service, and people ask me all the time, what do you think about the Tyre Nichols incident moving forward? And there are some points that I want to point out after watching the video and kind of seeing what's been going on in Memphis that I think will be really interesting to you. So two of the five officers I did patrol with personally and did have a personal relationship with two of the five. So I'm going to be talking from a personal standpoint and from a standpoint as a former Memphis police officer and what I see moving forward. And even though I know two of the five personally and have patrolled with them personally and had a relationship with them, this in no way excuses any of their actions that partook about 2 weeks ago with the Tyre Nichols incident.
All right, that is a good setup. He said it does not excuse them just because I know them. I understand that sentiment. There's more. Here it is.
The first thing I want to talk about, which is utter BS, is you'll see a lot of conservatives say, why did he run? He would still be alive if he ran. That's not a guarantee. So the first thing that came out was that this all started because this was a reckless driving. But now the chief of the department is saying that there is no evidence of reckless driving, which means you can't say that if he never ran that he would still be alive when the stop was illegal in the first place. Now, I have had to pull out people, rip people out of a car aggressively at gunpoint with foul language many a times. But most of those peoples were murderers, robbers, sexual assaulters, the worst of the worst, where you needed to meet violence with violence. Never once did I put my gun in the face of somebody who I suppose for reckless driving, right? So from the get-go, you have a man who was not guilty of anything fleeing from the police because he's scared, because he doesn't even know why he's getting pulled over in such an aggressive manner. So as a black male, I probably would have ran too, and I was the police for 5 years.
He makes an interesting but true statement. Now, he also said that he didn't know why he was being pulled over, talking about Mr. Nichols. Maybe he did. Maybe that's why he ran. Who knows? Nobody will actually know because he's dead. He has no due process anymore. Here's another video.
Number two, there is no way, form, or fashion that you take a police boot and you strike a man's face multiple times while he's on the ground. No form, no way, no fashion. There is no way that that is excusable. I don't care who you're fighting. A kick to the face right here, that can be lethal. And unless you're trying to intentionally kill somebody, that is not a tactic that is taught, nor should ever be used. Number three, if you are a police officer, I don't care how cool you are, people, you never, ever, ever let your fellow officer do anything that you wouldn't let be done to you. You are just as guilty as the lynch mobs who used to lynch black people and watch them die and get lynched, even though they never put a hand on them. You are just as guilty. And my last point, everybody from the beaters to the paramedics to the regular officers on the scene that stood there and watched is going to lose their job and should, because once you look at somebody, no matter what crime they did, and you take the human out of them, you have now also lost your humanity and now your freedom.
Let's put his picture up. Brandon Williams is his name. I wish he was still a cop, to be honest with you. Brandon Williams grew up in the same area he patrolled in East Memphis. That means he could see the humanity in the people he patrolled. They raised him. While he now lives in Dallas and is no longer an officer, he turned to TikTok to speak out about the Tyre Nichols murder. Williams' TikTok video has more than 600,000 views, and he said he'll continue answering questions as the investigation continues. He has done so far in two other videos specifically addressing rumors circulating around the case. Now, thank you, dear brother. Thank you for providing context and authentic truth to the reality that this never should have happened. These cops should be held accountable, even if you do know them. And at the end of it, the arrest or the stop was not justified. The police chief went on national television and said, we have no evidence of reckless driving. The Scorpion unit was created to stop reckless driving. That was part of their mission. No prerequisite of reckless driving can be found. We need current cops. You see, and that's the issue right there. A current cop can't say this. Why? Why can't a current cop say something about crime? You have to remember, they are in the arena, in the industry of law enforcement. They are supposed to be righteous administrators of the doctrine we know as statutory law. They can talk about crime. They can talk about criminals. They can talk about gangs. They can talk about people who rob. But then when the criminal, when the gangster is a cop, all of a sudden they are not allowed to speak about that. All right, Jordan, thoughts here?
Yeah, I thought this was really interesting. He seems to have a lot more faith in the system than most people. He seemed pretty confident that everybody who was in any way connected, in addition to losing their jobs, is also going to go to jail. I don't know. I hope so, but I don't know. We'll see. The system is so rigged that I have very little confidence. It's a shock that when we see one or two cops a year go to prison, serve any sentence whatsoever. It is surprising. So I don't necessarily share his optimism in that regard, but it was interesting to see an inside perspective on this case and hear someone who is even broadly within the world of the police condemning it.
Yeah. Need more like him.